We're back. I'm Emma.
And I'm Sarah.
And we're back with Sermon on Podcast announcements. I will start with the menu for the week. For today's lunch is orange chicken rice, fruit and veggie bar, and a fortune cookie. Tomorrow's breakfast is mini cinnamon rolls, and tomorrow's lunch is chicken noodle soup, crackers and cheese, and fruit and veggie bar and dinner roll. Thursday's breakfast is breakfast pizza, and Thursday's lunch is pig in a blanket, smile fries, and fruit and veggie bar. General news, if you or someone you know is struggling or in crisis, help is available. Call or text 988 or chat 988 Lifeline or Teresa 988 Susan versus Lifeline.
For Bobcat Academy meetings, on the 18th, there's a high school book club in Mrs. Whiting's class. Junior high basketball girls are to be dismissed at 11:30 for lunch today due to them leaving at noon for their game. Friendly reminder for any after-school activities, please read your Bobcat spectator responsibilities. And seniors, please email or get a copy of your senior pictures to Miss Funk.
Daily quote, we all make choices, but in the end, our choices make us. Andrew Ryan. Elementary news, also read through your Summerland Bobcat spectator responsibilities, please. All live stream links for sports and activities are in the announcements, and these are the sports activities for this week. For Tuesday today, there's junior high basketball at Santee, with the girls at 2 o'clock and boys at 3. There, for Wednesday tomorrow, there's a school board meeting at 6:30. For Thursday, there's wrestling duels at Mealy at 5. Junior high boys basketball at 4:30 at Summerland in the Ox Gym. Junior high girls tournament at Summerland at 3 p.m. Summerland versus St. Mary's. 4:15, there's O'Neill versus CWC. 5:30, there's a consolation game. And 6:45, there's championship game. Friday, there's JV girls and JV boys, varsity girls and varsity boys basketball at Osmond, and high school girls wrestling invite at Mealy at 4:30. Saturday, there's speech meet at Summerland, junior high boys basketball tournament at Westholt. Summerland B starts at 10, and Summerland A starts at 11:10. Games may start early. There's JV girls and boys basketball tournament at Niobrara, and high school boys wrestling at Mealy at 10.
For sports for next week, Monday, January 23rd, there's a late start for students. At 10:30, there's a KTCH Quiz Bowl versus Elkhorn Valley. High school basketball at Elkhorn Valley. And Tuesday, January 24th, there's high school basketball at Plainview. JV girls, JV boys, and girls varsity, and boys varsity. There's a wrestling try at Summerland, EPPJ, and North Central. And it's also wrestling parents night that night. Thursday, January 26th, there's Antelope County Career Day, high school basketball at Wausau. And then Friday, January 27th, there's Wayne State Honor Band, junior high basketball at Summerland versus St. Mary's girls and boys. And then high school wrestling invite at Central Valley. On Saturday, the first round NVC at Elkhorn Valley and EPPJ.
That's it for some Lynn Podcast announcements. Make sure to stay tuned for Olga's Top Tuner of the Week with Emily and Christian's Lucky Guest with Kelton and Jesse.
Everyone's Bobcast, and I'm here today with Emily Ollers for Top Senior of the Week. What sports do you participate in?
Basketball.
What is your favorite sport?
Basketball.
What activities / extracurriculars do you participate in?
FFA.
What are your plans after high school?
Go to college somewhere and go to become an equine physical therapist.
Who do you take for and why?
Miss Shutt, because Emma had her last year and I knew she'd be easy.
What is your favorite memory?
Probably when, God, I don't know, when Chipper and Colton got into a fight, that's about it.
What is your favorite class?
8th period Miss Schneider's class.
Who has been your favorite teacher throughout high school?
Miss Schneider.
When you were younger, what did you want to be?
A vet, I think.
What is your favorite childhood memory?
Probably just sledding all the time, I guess. Okay.
What is an accomplishment you are most proud of?
Probably my grades.
Where do you see yourself in 10 years?
Rich and living in the middle of nowhere.
What will you miss most about Summerlin when you graduate?
Probably just the friends I have here.
How have you changed since your freshman year?
I've become a lot nicer.
If you could start high school all over again, what activity would you participate in this time that you didn't before?
Track? I don't know.
I have some fun questions. If you had one wish, what would it be?
Probably just have as much money as I wanted.
And what advice would you give to juniors?
Do scholarships, and if you don't really want to go out for a sport, don't do it.
That has been Top Share of the Week with Emily Allers. Thank you.
As a lucky guest today, I'm here with
Kelton and Brian.
And
Jesse
and Teal.
Okay, who wants to get us started?
I think Jesse does.
No, Kelton starts.
Yep, Kelton starts. Okay, which is the only country to have played in each and every World Cup?
Argentina.
Bang, that's incorrect. Jesse?
Absolutely wrong. It is definitely. Wait,
it's so easy.
Every single one, even this year?
Yeah. The only country to have played in each and every World Cup.
Bro, Argentina.
It's not
that
Argentina.
Is such cap. I know it ain't Argentina.
It's so easy.
It ain't that one doing like that.
I know what one it is now.
Spain.
I think
no,
that's
it's
wrong.
England.
Dylan,
England.
It's England. It's Brazil? They were not in the last one. This is so dumb. I'm sold.
Okay, question for Jesse. Who was the first U.S. volleyball player to win 3 Olympic gold medals?
Michael Jordan.
No, he was in boxing or something.
He was in boxing.
To win 3 Olympic... Michael volleyball.
Amelia Earhart.
Nobody keeps up with women's sports.
That's just false.
Let's go with Jordan Larson. That's the only name I can pronounce.
Incorrect. Kelton, you have no points.
I know. That's why I'm going to go with Rachel Adams.
That is also incorrect.
Always have.
It's Karch.
Okay, Kelton's question. Who is the oldest heavyweight champion in boxing history?
No.
Hey, I think you
maybe.
Put that away, bud.
It's either George Foreman
or
it's Bob Fitzsimmons. Bob Fitzsimmons. Bob Fitzsimmons.
Hey, I ain't stealing.
That's incorrect, Jesse. You can steal.
Let's
Connolly was not a heavyweight.
Which one did he say? Bob
Fitzsimmons. He said this one.
I said all of the above.
George Foreman, like the grill. Live one!
Dang, that's correct.
I did not think it was him.
Alright.
No, no, I did.
Question for Jesse again. What sport did Sugar Ray Robinson's son play?
Well, he
what
was
is roller
a
derby.
Boxer.
Oh, really?
Well, it's not your question.
I'm gonna go with baseball. They always play baseball.
Incorrect. Kelton.
Who is his son?
Probably like Sugar Ray Robinson Jr.
Who is he?
It's boxing.
That is also incorrect.
I knew it was
roller derby.
Cause nobody does it.
All right. Question for Kelton.
Too much for me.
How many players are on the field for each team in an Australian rules football match?
Okay. I know this. It's either. It's not that. Is it 18 or is it 9?
I know who it is.
It's 9
for each team.
Oh, for each. 9.
Definitely not.
That's incorrect, Jesse.
I'm about to steal.
You guys do understand. Wouldn't Australian rules football be soccer?
No.
Is it not?
No.
I assumed it's soccer.
No. It's like rugby, but definitely.
It's probably 6, but I ain't guessing. I ain't stealing. You know what? Every time I say that, I'm wrong. I'm gonna go with 6.
That is incorrect.
Dylan, you are wrong.
Is it 12?
I think it is 12.
It's 18.
Dylan,
I knew it was 18.
Wrong.
All right, question for Jesse. How many years did it take the Atlanta Falcons to win their first playoff game?
18. Took forever.
18?
Yeah, look at that W. Oh.
Incorrect, Kelton.
See,
The Atlanta Falcons, it's a trick question. They've never been good.
I just
especially
said
especially not getting up in the playoffs.
I just said
that's why it took 1 year.
So you're probably wrong.
It took one.
Let's get our feet.
It took one.
That is cap.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Only six.
These are all impossible.
Alright. Is it your question, Dalton?
Yeah.
Which was the first African country to qualify for a World Cup?
Africa. Those are all African countries. Dang.
No, duh.
Yeah, I thought maybe they'd try to throw you off with like a Sweden or a
Norway.
Nicaragua.
Niger. I'm just naming off countries I know.
Ethiopia.
Okay, how about we answer the question?
Morocco.
Are you sure?
Wrong.
Yeah. That's incorrect.
I ain't stealing, but it's there.
It's Egypt.
It's incorrect.
It's Egypt.
Egypt ain't got nothing.
It got the pyramids and that's it.
And the Nile River.
Alright, question for Jesse.
The Nile is a river in Egypt.
Who won the first
Wimbledon?
What is Wimbledon?
It is soccer.
I'm going to go with Spencer Gore. Lyward.
What dang. The? That is correct.
W's all around.
God,
what position did rugby leader Martin Johnson play?
Colton.
MLK.
Was it the hooker, the prop, the locker, number 8? No, it was not. He was a hooker.
So he played the position of hooker?
No. I ain't stealing, but I'm going to go with prop.
Number?
It's lock.
All right, Jesse's question. Now, who owns the NFL record for most sacks in a single game?
Von Miller.
Bang, that's incorrect.
Reggie White.
I bet you Reggie ain't
it's
white.
It's Derek Thomas? Exactly! Who is Derek Thomas?
Alright, question for Kelton.
Calm down.
Which of the following was an NFL Offensive Rookie of the Year?
Okay. I know he was. And then, was he, though? I know he was.
Hey, how about we pick an answer?
I'm thinking. Tony Dorsett.
That's the wrong answer.
That is incorrect. Jesse, you can steal.
All of them. Kelvin's right and wrong.
Alright. We'll do like 2-3 more questions, baby. Jesse's question now. What wide receiver holds the record for most receptions in a single season? Jesse, got an answer?
I'm going to go with...
No.
Hey, how about we let him answer? Okay?
Jerry Rice!
No. That is incorrect. Kelton. Would you like this deal?
Can you just scroll back up on this?
Most receptions in a single season.
Randy Moss.
You sure?
Yeah.
That is incorrect.
It's Terrell.
It's Marvin Harrison.
Who even are these people?
You're selling me!
All right, Kelton's question. Which of the following players was selected earliest in the 2000 draft?
I know who it wasn't.
It's Tom Brady, okay? That's easy.
He was a first overround pick.
Wait, what's the question?
That's my question?
It's Kelton's question, I think.
No, I went Jesse Abbott. I'm going to steal it from him.
I'll give it to Kelton.
No, it's Jesse's question.
It's your question, Jesse.
Yes and no. Which of the following players is selected first? I'm going to go with...
I had the Randy Moss.
What's the one I had never heard of?
I had the Randy Moss.
Scroll down. I've heard of Brian, Tom, and...
It's
I'm
going to
go with Sebastian Jankowski.
That would be a good guess, but it's not your question.
That would be sad. It's mine.
I know it's not Tom Brady because he wasn't
Okay, can we answer
but
the question?
He is selling me. I already get the right one, and it's Sebastian. And that is helping you tell it.
Well, it's still him.
Dalton?
Hey,
what are you doing there?
Huh? Nothing, because I can get no reception in here. That's why I'm going with Sebastian. It's going to be
what
a bar.
What did I say?
That is
it's a bar!
I'm going to steal and go with... Wait, how many do I lose if I... I'm going to steal and go with LeVar. No, Cap! You need to give him 2 points for it.
Go, let's sell.
No, you did sell.
All right, that'll do it for today. Jesse beating Kelton 6-0 on Lucky Guess, and we'll see you next time.